And welcome to Fox Valley TV and our matchup here, a Northern Illinois Big 12 game between Yorkville and Plano. Yorkville Foxes being the home team. Plano Reapers joining us. Their starting five, Brandon Contreras, a senior, number one. Number 13, Nathan Shedd, a senior. Number 22, Elijah Masonette. He's a senior. Number 23, Anthony Martinez, a senior. And forward 24, Will Benson, also a senior. A veteran starting five for this team. We have seen a lot of talent out of this Plano group, and they are ready to bring an L to the home team, Yorkville, who's starting five. Start with Nick Owens, number two, the guard. At a guard, 6'1", number three, Alex Newman. Number 10, the forward, Jake Eberhardt. And at 6'6", playing post, a rebounding monster, 34, Jason Lewan. And a great Yorkville shooter on the outside, then also can duck in, rebound, and grab, number 40, Austin Avery. We've got some fantastic basketball set up here as the Yorkville Foxes come into this game looking to keep the home field advantage going. We just saw the girls team play some fantastic basketball, so let's see if the guys can do it as well. But Plano comes in with a lot of height, a lot of speed, and a lot of skill. So if anybody is going to challenge Yorkville, it is going to be this Reaper team here in purple. And Jason Lewan and 23 Anthony Martinez set for the tip. And we are set as Yorkville grabs the ball. Newman making moves around the outside. Find himself in the corner. He'll pass out to Lewan. And over to Owens, who will keep the dish going. Yorkville trying to find some space on the inside. Can't seem to get it inside. We'll pass it back out to Owens, who will send it to number 10, Eberhardt, who will up and no good. Rebound to Plano. Contreras will bring the ball up. And he'll dish out to Shedd, who will find in the corner for a no good shot in and out. That was number 23, Anthony Martinez. And they're going to give a foul to number 13, Nathan Shedd, who has been charged for a reach in. Yorkville starting out. We see Plano with this full court press that has done a lot of damage to a lot of teams before. Yorkville making moves, and he's trapped. Lewan to bail him out. Benson, no good. Oh, I'm sorry, that was Avery. Dishing in is Newman. He'll pass out to Owens. Lewan to Eberhardt. Back to Newman. To Owens. Yorkville really taking their time with this game. They're going to set it up and look for some space. Avery going to try to drive over. Not quite there. And no dish. So the rebound will go to Plano. Opportunity for number 13 and a block from Lewan. That shot from Nathan Shedd just couldn't get it past Lewan, even if it, he kind of went low there trying to get it around Lewan's height. And Lewan still came up with the block, but Plano will keep the ball. An opportunity for the dish inside. They'll send it out to Martinez, who will in and out. Plano maintains possession, trapped in the corner. And an open opportunity for Shedd. No good. So Austin Avery coming down with the rebound. And he'll be trapped, but he'll slip after being pushed according to the officiating staff, by Brandon Contreras, who will pick up his first foul, the team's first foul as well. And Owens will step out. Stepping in is Habata. So Alex Noman will bring the ball up over to Avery, who will drive flawlessly up and in. That'll be 2-0, I'm sorry. And a quick answer by Plano. 2-2, and that shot from Eliza Masonette. That give and go quick in the corner is normally the first move for Yorkville. See if Plano catches up on that as they try to dance around. It'll be a foul on, looked like it was number one, Brandon Contreras. After a little bit of contact on the wing. So Adiati steps in for the Reapers. Avery will dish out to Lewan. We'll send it out to Habata. Lewan into Avery, will try to make the move, and up and in. The and one, Austin Avery, showing his worth. That'll be 4 points to him, the only 4 points on the board for Yorkville. And he will go to the line and try to make it a 3-point play. Elijah Masonette was given the foul. That'll be his first, Plano's fourth already. Shots in and good. Austin Avery shooting off to a great start. He's got 5 points. A tip away, Habata will grab the steal. Shot up and they'll call the charge. So Habata will be charged with the offensive foul. And let's see if this new swing of momentum can prove worthy for Plano, as a little bit of a wet spot in the court, I'm guessing. Slip up by Sheed. Shots up, and no good off the front of the backboard, but a quick rebound by Plano, and the jump ball will... No, they'll call it a foul, so... Looks like... Looks like that'll be a foul on Newman. So dish in. 13, Sheed. We'll try to make the drive, runs through one too many. Yorkville Foxes, actually, I figured they'd be called for an offensive foul, but they'll charge him with the travel. So Austin Avery will dish in Yorkville ball regardless. And a travel as well on Noman. You can see that refs are cracking down. Once they catch one player doing it, they're going to be watching the feet. Both players trying to make drives that started a little bit too early. That'll be Sheed over to Adiodi. And a big three. For Plano, coming from Anthony Martinez. It'll be 5-5. That'll tie the game up. Habata. Over to Eberhardt, who won't be able to make it, but he will pull in the rebound and a jump ball. Looks like in favor of Plano. Yes. Saw the ref coming to the table. Thought it might have been a foul, but it will be cleanly fielded, so Plano ball. And now Sheed has an opportunity to possibly take the lead here, as Adiodi will be stopped after getting trapped in that corner. Possible drives, Lewan won't make the move, but there will come a drive from Yorkville as they're trying to just find any space again. Eberhardt up for the three, no go. Adiodi with the rebound. Quick dish. What a pass from Adiodi. What a finish from number 22, Elijah Masonette. And now Plano on a little bit of a hot streak. Eberhardt holding on, slowing things down. Newman, keep it up top. 21 more. We'll dish back to Newman. Newman trying to drive. We'll get it poked away. And we'll end up with it, but Masonette, I'm sorry, will find himself with the ball after a little bit of a struggle. Number 13 up for the three. That's good. Sheed with his first 3 points of the game from way downtown. 10-5, Plano leading. Moore over to Lewan. Over to Newman. Out to Abada. Back to Nelman. And cross to Lewan. Moore with an opportunity. Up and in. The putback for Lewan wanted that putback, but Moore was able to finish. An impressive stretch. 7-10 right now. Yorkville down. Plano. Martinez in the corner. I'm sorry, Masonette in the corner. And Moore will end up with it. And a big block from Elijah Masonette, who has started this game dominating on both the offensive and defensive side. He's got 4 of Plano's 10 points, and not to mention 2 blocks now. And Plano, with this momentum swing, brings in the height. 6'8", number 15, Jermaine Boyd steps onto the court. Adiodi. These kind of desperate passes. Shots up, go looking for another one, is Sheed, but no go, looks like. Trying to figure out a call. Refs asking the players to just be careful. Getting a little bit too physical in the paint. When you've got two players who are used to dominating the paint, going up against each other, neither of them wants to give any way. And those two players, Austin Avery and Jermaine Boyd, are two defensive powerhouses in the post. As Abada brings it up. Yorkville holding on to it, slowing it up a little. Avery over to Habata. Shots up, no good, but it's saved by Owens. Plano will maintain possession. Will Benson trapped, making a quick move. Opportunity from Adiodi, up and in, and one. The crowd comes to their feet. What a move by Adiodi. And he'll go to the line. And Ethan Key will step in for Plano. So Izzy Adiodi, a powerhouse on the football field, finds himself at the line and playing some great basketball as well. Yorkville will set itself up. Austin Avery holding on top. Over to Habata. Outside, shots up from 22. Turner, no go, rebound. Ethan Key. Sheed will have an opportunity to push and will get pushed. And that foul on 22, Bradley Turner. So that'll be his second, the team's 4th foul of the game. Habata will step off, looks like. Owens and Nauman will now join us. Plano holding it back. Sheed holding it up top. Sheed with the push. Up and the drive, oh my! What a move by Nathan Sheed. Oh, no, he's called for the offensive foul. My apologies. So he'll be called for his second, the team's sixth. That was just about one of the best moves I've seen in high school basketball, but unfortunately, the offensive foul looks like there's going to be a push off in the paint. So Boyd will be called for the off-ball foul. I'm sorry, Ethan Key called for the off-ball foul. Going up against Austin Avery, that'll be Plano's seventh foul, Key's first. And Avery finds himself at the line. Once again, you see those powerhouses in the paint going at it, don't want to give up an inch, and can, you know, get a little too physical. And Boyd comes down with a great rebound, so that'll set up Plano to make a, hopefully, drive to end it as 30 seconds ticks down in the first quarter. Shots up and in by Brandon Contreras. That'll be a three-point play, so he'll find himself on the board. 16-7. Avery in the corner, up to Newman. They'll try to make a move. There's a push. And it looks like there'll be a push off by number one, Brandon Contreras. That'll be the team's eighth foul. And already in the first quarter, that is Contreras' third of the game. Already finding himself in some foul trouble. Newman will miss the first, but Avery will come down. Both will come down, Boyd and Avery, so they're going to give the jump ball, and Plano will end up with it. I'm sorry, Yorkville will end up with it. Little confusion, shots up, no good, and a... Looks like when he came down, Mezzanette took a little walk. So it'll stay Yorkville ball with 2.9 seconds left. 16-7, Plano Reapers leading. So once again, refs trying to intervene, making sure the players stay fair. Eberhardt will send it up. Last second three from Newman. No good. Boyd will come down with the rebound. And that will conclude our first quarter of play. Plano 16, Yorkville 7. Keep it right here on Fox Valley TV.
Ah, it's a great day, isn't it?
Yeah. Too bad your boat's going to sink at 11:05.
Don't come closer. I have rabies.
Don't you wish there were warnings to protect you from life's risks? With diabetes, there is one. It's called A1C, a simple blood test that helps measure your risk of serious complications. Learn more at diabetesa1c.org.
And we're back here on Fox Valley TV. If you're just joining us, it is the Yorkville Foxes versus the Plano Reapers here in Yorkville. A foul-stricken Plano has been playing basketball the way they do best, although the refs are very strict on both sides so far, so the physical basketball has been kind of made way for a lot of athleticism, and Plano winning that bout 16-7 as Key steps up, and the big man outside steps from the three, will miss. Yorkville ball. Avery to Owens, to Lewan, back to Newman. Yorkville playing a pass game, playing very smart. Eberhardt gonna try to send it into Avery, who will beat Key, but will be charged for the push. So an offensive foul just a travel on Austin Avery. Adiotti showing his speed, dishes out to Key, who will hit the three. He draws Lewan out from the post. What a move by Key. You'd never expect a gentleman who's so dominant in the post to be able to step out and make that three. Pulls Lewan. Yorkville defense falls back on their heels, and Key is able to make a great three. Plano 19, Yorkville 7. Yorkville playing the game they know best, but can't seem to find the get the ball into the basket. They've been playing the same gentleman over and over again. The boys mainly are Eberhardt, Newman, and Lewan Avery, those four. Owens has definitely put in his time as well. You can see that maybe that they're drawing up a little bit of a difference in that huddle, but Yorkville finds itself in a situation that they're not normally used to, and that's being down by more than 10. Like I said, the score right now, 19-7, Plano winning here on the road. And both teams will step back out of their huddles. So Yorkville starts off with the ball. Avery dishes into Owens. To Newman. The two-man full-court press has slowed down Yorkville a little bit. It's hard to say if it's been helping or hurting, although the scoreboard may say hurting. Lewan into Avery. Back to Lewan. Owens. Opportunities. Airballed. And Avery attempts to make the save, but is on the ground as he makes the toss. So Plano with the opportunity here. The athleticism of Odiotti. I should say Adiotti, my apologies. As Plano tries to make a drive, missing that. Out to Adiotti. Keen to, and stolen by Lewan. Newman will drive it up. Owens with the three. I'm sorry, that was Habata with the three. So Logan Habata picks up his first 3 points of the game. A steal by Habata, who will go up, and he'll be fouled by Adiotti. The way down. And that'll send Habata to the line. Plano's ninth foul of the half. And that'll be Adiotti's first foul of the game. Habata makes his first. One more shot. Yorkville very strong from the line. Habata makes both. And it is 12-19. They'll be trapped up top. Mazinet has to make an athletic grab. He's trapped. Over to Key. We'll dish it way out to Martinez. Gets it inside to Key, who makes a fantastic move for the and one. The athleticism of these two teams is absolutely outstanding. And on this case, Mason Key, who is a very powerful player, makes a great move and sweeps right, gets around defenders, finds himself on the line as they come down in a panic. So Newman with a cut will step aside. Joining us for Yorkville is Bradley Turner. Key at the line. Will make his first with ease, a 3-point play. It is 22-12, Plano leading. The full court press makes Yorkville have to think twice about its moves. Abada with a cross will make it over the line. Adiotti coming out to challenge Abada. Turner dishes in. Opportunity out to Abada. No three, Masonette. Oh, Abada will step out. And rebound grabbed by Plano's Will Benson. Martinez will set up. Dishes to Masonette. To Adiotti. Up for three. No go. Rebound. That's 21 Moore. JaVale Moore, I should say. Abada setting up the play. To Turner. Back to Abada. Out to Turner. Trying to make a move. Yorkville can't seem to find a way into Plano's defense. Eberhardt. And open Abada for three. Will make it. 3 points, Logan Abada. 15-20, Plano leading. Adiotti can't make the move, and it'll wind up with a timeout, a quick call as he was in jeopardy of traveling there. A great move by Bradley Turner. So it'll be a jump ball. My apologies. Did not get the timeout off in time. Martinez will try to drive. Dish to Benson. Up and in, as his team seemed to be a little less physical under the post now that the refs have really cracked down on contact. Turner to Eberhardt. Into Moore. He'll get up and over the 6'8 Boyd. 2 points to JaVale Moore. Missing that. Tries to dish inside, but no go. Lewan will pick it up, and a steal back from Benson, so we're right back where we started. Martinez with a long three, no go. And Yorkville called for stepping out and then the push, if I'm correct. Yep, so they're going to... Oh, I'm sorry. They're going to call it on Plano's Will Benson for the reach-in. Now they find themselves in the double bonus, so Yorkville shooting two regardless. Eberhardt, not someone at the line you really want, as he makes his first, bringing this game into 6 points, 18-24. With 3 minutes, 34 seconds left in the half. Eberhardt makes both. 5 point game, 19-24. Plano to Martinez to Sheed. Little Dyson, shot on target, no go, just short. And Abada will wind up with it. Out to Eberhardt for three. That's a no-go, but Moore will wind up with the rebound, and a whole swarm of Plano will wind up on top of Moore. So he'll shoot two. And the call ends up on Martinez. Moore will shoot from the line. And a great shot at that. Only a junior, Moore has seen some experience, but playing very strong at the varsity level currently. As he'll make his second as well, it is 21-24. These fouls are absolutely killing Plano. Sheed over to Benson. Benson up and not quite. Dancing around, had to make a decision, said no, so it'll wind up in Yorkville hands. Moore with an opportunity to drive and a charge. will be called. So offensive foul on Bradley Turner. Again, the contact game on both these teams, very smart play. So Sheed will start with it over to Masonette. Masonette with the drive. Not quite there. Keen tried to reach in and off Turner. So that'll wind up. Oh, I'm sorry, off Keen. Turner will check out. Owens checks in. And a steal for Benson. What a move, lightning quick. Stays calm under pressure. She dishes out Martinez for the three. No go, but Benson will pull the rebound in easily. He'll go back up in the post. 2 points to Plano, 2 points to Will Benson. 26-21 with 2 minutes left in the half. Yorkville brings it up. Newman picking his choices wisely, sends it over to Owens. They're gonna play a little back and forth. Inside to Moore, and what a move by Moore to get up and over Keen. 2 points Yorkville. 3 point game with a minute 30 left, and they're gonna call the push off on Sheed. What a sell on that play. So Sheed's gonna wander over to the bench. They're gonna pull him. Being his third foul, he's already getting into trouble, and that's one that you can't really play without if you're Plano. That's your main guard right there. As Avery brings the ball up. Newman tries to get over. Avery open, calling for it. Austin Avery playing catch up top. Dish out, opportunity for Abada. Not quite. Moore trying to go back up and will draw the foul from Keen, who has been playing it very safe, but just got to find that fine line between safe and still playing defense. So Key picks up his second foul, Plano's 12th. Still the first half as Moore sends up another and misses. Austin Avery pulling the rebound down. Abada tosses it way over to Owens. They'll play catch up top. Just takes under a minute. Habata up for the three, in and out. And Key comes up with it. Adiodi, good dish to Maisonette, who lays it in. Maisonette's got 6 points on the day. 30 seconds. Yorkville looking to the coach for the play. And playing the clock, sends it over to Abada. Looks like they're just going to run it out for one final play. And Abada inside, tries for the dish, no go. Keel lined up with it. And the cross-court shot, no good. So after two halves of fantastic basketball, we've still got a very close game between the Plano Reapers and the home team, the Yorkville Foxes. 23-28, Plano leading here on the road. So stay tuned, this is a can't-miss game here on Fox Valley TV.
Real men know that getting tested is the way to take care of their families. That's why real men wear gowns. For a list of the tests you need, go to AHRQ.gov.
And welcome back to Fox Valley TV. If you're just joining us, you have missed a wonderful first half of boys basketball here in Yorkville. The Plano Reapers leading the Yorkville Foxes 28-23, but it has been back and forth all day. Two very physical teams, two very athletic teams, trading blows here in a great matchup as we start the second half of what is sure to be more exciting basketball as they dish in. Austin Avery ends up with it. Eberhardt over on the three-point line, finds himself some space and scores what seemed to be an easy three for him. So Plano on the other end. Martinez, DeSheed, long three, answers flawlessly. Made no noise going through the basket whatsoever. Finds himself at 31-26. Like I said, these two teams have been absolutely trading blows, very evenly matched. Dish out. Owen struggles with the quick pass. Newman. Avery finds himself cornered. Sorry. Owens over to Eberhardt, who just about does it again, but it's in and out, and a call. Looks like they're going to call Benson. They're going to call Will Benson for the push off with an attempt to get a rebound. So that'll be his second, the team's first of the half. Just out to Newman. Owens on the corner. Back up top. And Newman over to Eberhardt. Back up top. He's going to try to drive. Tries to dish into Lewan, but will fall off of Martinez's knee. And there's a call to be made somewhere. And I believe it was just the out of bounds. So Fox's ball. Lewan finds it up top over to Avery. To Owens, who's up and no good. Rebound, Benson, who got way up in the air. Sheed with an opportunity, dishes to Martinez, who is very successful from the line, but this one goes in and out, and it'll fall off of, we're waiting for the call here. So they'll call it on Owens, and he'll be charged with the push. That'll be his first foul, team's first of the half. Martinez dishes up the Sheed. Back to Contreras, and it'll go way up in the air. Lewan come down with it. Avery over to Newman, who will keep it back up top. Avery, what a move, what a heads-up play. Some great pass, great shot. Austin Avery comes down with 2 points. Mazanet, I should say, tries to dish in. What would have been a great block by Lewan is dashed by the Austin Avery reach-in. So he'll pick up his first and the team's second. You can tell how smart he's been playing this game. Avery, who normally can wind up with a few fouls here and there in a physical game of basketball, will actually get charged again. So Austin Avery actually picks up his second in this about 15-second time span, a warning to the Plano bench. Maisonette will... Oh, they're going to call Avery yet again for holding Maisonette. Looked like he got the waistband. So in the span of three plays, Avery finds himself in foul trouble here in the second half. So Benson will dish into Martinez, who's going to go up and not quite over Lewan as a big hand gets up and puts it right back down into Martinez's face. Yorkville with an opportunity. Eberhardt dishes into Turner. Lewan. I'm sorry, that was Moore. Hibata over to Eberhardt, trying to get it inside, but can't seem to do it. Newman, with a long two, and it'll end up off of Lewan, so Plano ball. Sheed will start and bring it up for Plano. To Martinez, all the way across to Contreras, and who took a step before he dribbled. Knocking the dust off of his shoes a little bit there. Sometimes you just gotta be one step ahead of the game when you're playing basketball here against a great team like Yorkville, but unfortunately you can't get too far ahead of yourself, as we've seen a few players on Plano do. Newman tries to make a move. Plano's defense holding true. She dishes up. Obata with a struggled shot. He'll jump in, dish in with a quick attempted jump, but no go. Martinez to Contreras. Trying to use his speed, can't seem to do it. Eberhard doing a very good job of keeping up with Contreras. Long three from Sheed, who is untouchable when you let him step out that far. Sheed picks up his ninth point. Oh, a hard dish in. Newman overthrows. Now Martinez on the other way around. A finger roll won't go in. A little bit of a hook shot, I should say. And a little bit of both. But that'll wind up a foul on number three, Newman. He'll be charged with holding. Boyd steps in for Plano. Selena steps in for Yorkville. Up to Boyd using his height. He'll dish out. And instead of setting it up top, Plano's going to run with it. Maisonette can't seem to get a hold of a quick, hard pass, so Newman sets over to Eberhard, who sets up for the three, and he'll air ball. Newman recovers. Moore with an opportunity, and is blocked by Boyd, who is open, tries to dish in, no go, and Salinas will take the fall, but there'll be a foul before the call, so the ball will fall out of bounds. Yorkville with an opportunity. Trapped in that double team. They find it inside to Moore, who will jump up and in. Yes, so it will count as an and one and send Moore to the line. A foul on Boyd, that's his second and the team's second overall. So Moore has an opportunity to land the three-point play. And no go. Maisonette winds up with it. Sheed will bring the ball up. Plano going to hopefully extend their lead, which is only 4 points now with about 3 minutes, 30 seconds left. Sheed for the three, and it'll bounce off the rim, up and over, out of bounds, Yorkville ball. Like I said, the lead only four now, as Yorkville has had a little bit of a run, although it has been plagued with a few fouls and a few missed shots on both ends of the court. Moore with an opportunity, only has to go against. What a move by JaVale Moore to get around the 6'8 Boyd, who's got a little bit of a smile on his face as he backs up. Knowing that was an insanely athletic move, as Habata takes the steal, uses the momentum, tries to get the drive. Maisonette cannot land the block, and Yorkville goes on a run. Tie game, 34-34. Timeout, Plano. Habata with a move that seemed like it was plagued just to be blocked by Maisonette, who has a great defensive streak going so far. but somehow contorts himself to get up and over to make the move. But let's talk about the JaVale Moore move. Absolutely stunning. This Plano team is kind of falling back on their heels a little bit. You can tell some of them are getting a little tired, although the you got to give credit where credit is due. A team that was plagued by fouls in the first half is playing some very intelligent basketball come the second half. So Plano will bring the ball up. Sheed over to Contreras. To Maisonette. Tries to drive, can't do it. Contreras tries as well. Sheed will bring it back out for the long three, and it's good. I cannot believe Yorkville keeps letting him take that shot. That is 12 points. If I'm correct, he is 3 for 3 when more than 2 feet away from the three-point line. And there'll be a foul on number three, Nauman. So that'll be his third foul of the game, Yorkville's sixth foul of the game. You can tell they're trying to claw their way back, playing some more aggressive basketball. By the way, the foul board looks. Plano starting off very aggressive, and as Maisonette tries to drive, and the hook is up and in. 39-34 Plano. Like I was saying, Maisonette with a great steal as he dishes in. And he'll do what he does best, make a smart move. And now the timeout will come from Yorkville. So once again, the give and take, what looked like could have been a possibly game dominating run is quickly smashed and overtaken by the Plano run, which is currently happening. The momentum swings in this game have been absolutely outstanding. Plano, like I said, playing some very conservative basketball, and it almost looks like they're a little bit more in their comfort zone, especially defensively. These fast breaks coming with limited fouls. Yorkville, obviously playing a little bit more of aggressive basketball style, trying to get back into the lead, finds themselves kind of racking up the foul, almost a switch of roles between the first half and now the second. These two great programs are really taking chunks out of each other. Two physical teams as well, but they both play basketball better than some of the best teams in Illinois. And Yorkville will take it. Moore to dish in. Eberhardt going to try to take it up. And instead, it'll dish to Owens. Eberhardt, a fantastic basketball player, but a little tall to be a strong dribbler. Oh, and what a pass. Habata in, and he'll make the easy jump. And they'll grab two. Habata scores his 12th point. Coming off the bench. Oh, Sheed from downtown. The first miss from that long-range three. Ball comes off Boyd and falls out of bounds. Habata leading the team in points coming off the bench. Avery in will dish to Owens. Habata brings it up. Strong dribbler will fall into Owens. And a dive from Benson won't be successful, so Yorkville holds on, and Abada's going to slow things down, bringing it back up top. Avery will do the same, giving it to Lewan. Just trying to make room, and a big hit from Will Benson. So Will Benson called for the push on Avery, who took a pretty hard hit. I'm surprised he was able to bounce back so quickly. Eberhardt to toss it in for Yorkville. He'll dish to Owens. Avery's got space, but not anymore. Some great moves. They're getting tangled up a little bit down in the paint. Avery going to dish out to Lewan. Slow things down a little bit as the third quarter ticks under a minute. About over to Avery. Whoa, and they get tangled up once again. Play continues, though. And the refs really letting them play basketball here. 35 seconds left in the third quarter. They're going to keep moving it around the arc. Yorkville, a patient team. Eberhardt wide, can't seem to do it. Lewan can't seem to make it. So Sheed will wind up for it, and they'll get tangled up again. Sheed goes down hard. Finally, a foul called on, I believe that was 10, Eberhardt out of frustration. A lights out three shooter who is unfortunately struggling today. And he'll make his first and head over to the bench, take a little breather. Being able to watch Eberhardt last year, some great, great basketball played from that kid. Can step out and shoot the three, almost lights out, but unfortunately today struggling against a very strong Plano defense as Sheed makes his first free throw. And Contreras will step in for the shooter after the shot. So Plano making a few moves and no go on the rebound. Avery standing strong, getting the toss over to Habata. Shots up from Habata, which won't quite land. 3 seconds left, block from Avery, and Mizanet tosses it, and wow, can't get much closer than that. So after three quarters of play, it is only a six-point game. The Reapers, 42, the home team Yorkville, 36. Keep it here for an exciting fourth quarter coming up on Fox Valley TV.
Listen, I know you're upset, but it was just one date, and dating's like the stock market. There's ups and downs and ups. And so always buy low.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
And welcome back to Fox Valley TV here in Yorkville. We've got a fantastic matchup between the Foxes and Plano, truly playing out 42-36, only a six-point game between these two teams. Both playing some very physical basketball, both playing some very smart basketball. It is going to really come down to this fourth quarter and possibly the last few seconds if this game is played out the way that it has so far. Plano will start with the ball and an attempted steal by Nauman, but won't make it. A block by Lewan. What a move by. And I'm going to have to sort that one out. I'm sorry. Adiodi makes the jump into the stands to try to save it. Will save it, but it'll still bounce out of bounds. So. Oh, I'm sorry. No, there was a foul on Boyd for the reach before it fell out of bounds, so it'll be Yorkville ball regardless. Boyd's third foul, the team's fourth. Dish inside, Avery using Lewan as a human shield. Doesn't quite work out as Plano gets the rebound. Mazanet, a great move. He is thrown down. And Mazanet will find himself going to the line. And that one on Avery, that'll be his fourth. So he is going to step out. Obviously a player you want to save for later. I'm surprised they are utilizing him now with him already being in a little bit of foul trouble. Now even more so in foul trouble. That's his fourth. Maisonette, a rare miss. Newman will bring it up over to Owens, and they'll keep it up on the top. Abada, they're really trying to play with Abada. Owens, no push. They're going to keep it on the outside. He'll dish into Lewan. No go, cross court. And the 6'6 postman sends an airmail a little too far over the head of Habata. Can't say I blame him. Logan Habata, only 5'10", plays like he's much taller. Defensive powerhouse coming off the bench here for Yorkville. Good dish. Maisonette showing his ball handling skills up and over. JaVale Moore, fantastic play. 2 points, Maisonette, 44-36, 8-point game. Dish in, Nauman trying to find space, can't seem to do it. Owens, he'll keep it moving around the arc. Trying to get it inside, DeMore, not quite the power to get it, but Contreras will sneak in. I was expecting that to be an offensive rebound. Contreras showing his speed. Benson, over to Maisonette. And he'll send it to finally makes his way around to Contreras. I'm sorry, that was Adiodi. Who will show his ball handling skills. Sent out to Maisonette, up for three, and it's good. Plano on a little bit of a run, 47-36, find themselves up 11 on the road. Yorkville now twice in a row, kind of caught sleeping on defense. So a much needed timeout from Yorkville as they try to get themselves back in this game. With an 11-point lead, you can definitely tell that Plano is settling back, playing some conservative basketball. What I did catch me by surprise is the amount of passing that Yorkville's willing to make around that spot. Very patient. They definitely know how to use their time wisely. They've got a great coaching staff over in Yorkville. Mike Dunn has been head coach for now little while, and he's definitely showing his worth against some of the harder teams in conference and out. He's kept his team calm-headed, and in this game, Yorkville, coached by Kyle Key and Dan Taylor, two gentlemen who, for the Reapers, have been definitely utilizing their players well, bringing the best out of their team. So when I say that these two teams are evenly matched, it's right down to almost every last statistic, almost height. A lot of aggressive advantages. Both teams love to play basketball in the paint and do it their way. And this one is definitely going to come down to the wire. Moore inside, and he'll step before dribbling. Plano ball. Those small mistakes have been adding up right now against Yorkville. You can see it by the scoreboard, 11-point lead from Plano. Although we've seen a few of these leads and they all seem to diminish fairly quickly. Maisonette trying to dish up, won't be able to make it, and Boyd cannot bring it in. Lewan making it very hard on him. So it'll fall out of bounds. Shedd will step in. They're saving Maisonette for a little later in the game. We've still got 5 minutes left to play. This game is nowhere near over. Moore making a great move up and in, and that'll be an and one. So Moore will find himself on the line once again. Jermaine Boyd's height kind of biting him back as he called for the reach over. JaVale Moore makes his free throw. And checking out will be Boyd. Checking in will be Maisonette once again. So Boyd into foul trouble. no doubt he'll be utilized as time expires. Got plenty of height still on the court. Martinez, who is dangerous in both the post and from the three line, is in. Adiodi with a great pass over to Shed, who will turn and shoot, no go, but is right there to try to get the rebound. Owens finds himself on the three line. No go. Maisonette cannot get to it, so Yorkville will retain. And a tough reach in from Shed. Abadi finds himself at the, it'll be from the side, Benson will step in. As Shed steps out, he finds himself with four fouls as well. That is three Plano Reapers who are now with four fouls. There's still 4.5 minutes left in this game. Abadi over to Eberhardt, to Owens. They'll keep the dish no matter who's playing on the line. Oh, and a great steal from Plano. Adiodi to Contreras. Back to Maisonette. To Benson, who's got an open three off the front of the rim. Not quite there. Moore trying to score in transition. And Benson will be unable to set his feet, so he'll be charged with the block. Or the foul, I'm sorry. That'll be his third foul of the game. Plano's seventh. And Moore will take a shot, unfortunately misses first. Eight-point game. Moore takes a shot and will not make a second either. Ball comes down with Plano. Those are shots you really need when you're down only 8 points. Maisonette with a great move to Martinez. He is quick to make it to the open part of the court. Abadi pushing, no go. Lewan dish out to Abadi again. He'll shoot it up and no go. Lewan going over the back. And they'll find himself in the bonus. So that'll be his second, the team's ninth. And Adiodi to the line. Up and in, extends the lead back to 11 points. 3.5 minutes left here, 50-39, Plano Reapers up. Up and, oh, no good, looked good. Did not drop in. Yorkville with the recovery. Gonna try to make something of this drive. Eberhardt up and in, 3 points. To Jake Eberhardt, it'll make another three. Pull this back to an 8-point game. Just when you think Yorkville's out of it, they find a way to put themselves back in. And a block, a surprising no call from a little bit of contact there. It'll fall off, I believe, Lewan Plano ball. Maisonette will pass in. Contreras with the safe call. Trying to find room, and he's got plenty with Benson, but that, the small amount of space that he had to work with closed very quickly. But a little bit of panic mode from Yorkville finds themselves fouling. That's Lewan will pick up his third. That's the team's 10th, so Benson will shoot two from the line. Double bonus. And he will miss his first. And makes the second. 9-point game. 51-42, Plano leading here on the road. Abada dishes inside. Moore loses it. Makes contact with his face. Actually, there's a steal. I don't think Yorkville notices quite yet. Eberhardt, Eurostep, and in for the shot. Contreras trying to answer, and a reach-in will be tough call, but it'll wind up Plano ball. Mizanet took a hard elbow to the face. Hopefully he's okay. Keeps checking on his face. Shed to take it up. Very heads-up player. Dishes out to Adiotti. Contreras. He'll try to drive. Can't quite make it. Martinez outside. No go. And rebound will stay with Plano. And there'll be a timeout. 30-second timeout for Plano. So Plano, first thing they got to do is when they walk into the huddle, they've got to be able to maintain this lead because they've had it, but they've been in jeopardy a few times of losing it. With only 2 minutes left on the clock, you got to feel pretty safe as long as you continue to do what you're currently doing. You can play some safe basketball. These are two teams who have definitely been able to read each other on a lot of cases. Yorkville, being down, has been playing a little out of their comfort zone, which is that aggressive style of defense. Got themselves in a little bit of trouble, mainly in fouls. They're already in the double bonus, so any attempted drive can lead to possible Plano points, which you really can't let up when you're down this much with only 2 minutes left in the game. ...51-44, Plano dishes in. Shed set to set it up. Adiotti over to Mazanet. They're definitely playing from the top of the court. They know they've got time. Adiotti, they're keeping it around the outside. Plano killing a lot of time. Yorkville coming out to get a little pressure. And the pressure indeed works. Moore will make the pass. Did he have his feet set? And the refs say no. So they'll charge Shed with his fifth. And Shed fouls out. 8 fouls for Plano. Moore from the line. Makes his first. Number 22, Bradley Turner. The bench mob coming off. Absolutely dominating for Yorkville. I'm sorry, that's Mazanet, the stat sheet. Plano setting up and will drag his back left foot. Saw it clearly. Javale Moore is who I was referring to, my apologies, who has been dominating with his 17 points. Once again, for every reaction, there's an equal and opposite reaction. And for every great move Mazanet can make, Javale Moore finds himself deep in Plano defenders and is able to make himself out with 2 points. That'll be a 30-second timeout. This is a 3-point game. 51 49. Plano leading here on the road. Yorkville has got to be struggling to find a game plan that they can one-up with Plano. Both very smart teams, but, I mean, there's a limit to, you know, what Mike Dunn can do. He's got some fantastic talent on his team that can do some damage against a team who's a little back on their heels, but with this timeout, Plano gets a chance to recover a little bit. Both teams with fresh game plans that should last on the last 60 seconds here. This one may just come down to the wire, these two programs. Even the sophomore teams ended up in quadruple overtime. Adiodi goes to drive, is fouled. And that will be on number 3, it's Nauman. And he'll pick up what I believe to be his 4th. So Adiodi finds himself on the line, shooting 2. He will make his first. Come down to a nail biter here in the 4th. Adiodi trying to extend the lead to 5, makes it. So that'll be out of bounds and a mess up on Eberhardt's part. So Will Benson will find himself on the line passing in for Plano. A 4-point game. And a timeout called by Plano. Looks like almost both coaches were looking to make that call as soon as they got the ball back. So a full timeout by the Reapers. Yorkville playing some impressive basketball, but running out of gas a little bit. One of the players who you know can play the entirety of the game is Austin Avery, and he finds himself in foul trouble. He's got 4 fouls. Risking him in the paint is a, you know, it's a tough call on the shoulders of the coaching staff over for the Foxes. Lewan, a big-time defender, but not the scorer that Austin Avery is. But on the other end, you find Plano, who's, they've already got one player fouled out, and that's their lead guard, Nathan Shedd, who has been really dominating the game, just ball handling wise, keeping the Plano's some very heads up offense. He's been really making some impressive passing, getting a lot of players open. And now that they're missing that, Benson can do it, but not quite what Shedd can. As Maisonet, one of their ball handlers, will try to drive up and is fouled by Turner, who will get his 4th foul. That's, I've lost track of Yorkville's fouls. Maisonet set to shoot 2. Makes his first, extends the lead. 5-point game. Both players, or both teams, I should say, discussing what they're going to do to be able to get this back. Maisonet makes both. There's a 6-point game, 45 seconds left. Yorkville could be in a little bit of trouble here. Eberhardt open in the corner, but a long shot from Habadi does not go in. Plano will hold onto the ball, try to make some space, and Mizanet tries to extend the lead and can't. 25 seconds left. Moore with an opportunity. A dish out, and what looked to be an attempt to get around the block was thrown too far. Falls out. Plano now has possession. 18 seconds left in the game. The press proves not to be a problem for Plano as JaVale Moore jumps in to foul. That'll be his first team's, I believe, 14th. Bizanet. Makes not one, but two to seal the deal for Yorkville. Long three is no good, but Yorkville will end up with it. Eberhardt, 7 seconds left, tries to take a desperation shot, no go, tries it again, and will make the three as time expires. Final score here at Yorkville. Plano Reapers come in and play a great game of basketball with a fantastic team from Yorkville, but will come out ahead 57-52. Got a few people to thank here at Fox Valley TV. Without these guys, this fantastic program wouldn't occur. Our producer and director, Mike Reynolds, the gentleman on cameras, Felix Fontanez and Victor Mejia, and on YouTube, Master Control, Zach Gutzweiler. From all of us here at Fox Valley in Yorkville, thank you for watching and have a good night.